Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, Indian School of Physics. Guys, this is Nitin here, and today I have come with a very important concept of JEE Advanced. So this is a question which can definitely come in the exam. Guys, this video is brought to you by Indian School of Physics and Unacademy together. And name of this problem is dielectric sphere and potential. So guys, my current courses on Unacademy are course of INPHO Foundation and JEE Advanced 2023. And IMAGE for JEE 2023 already has started from 14th May, and advanced problem solving course of JEE Advanced 2021 is happening in special classes. These are free classes, anyone can access, and we are going to discuss some of the finest problems of physics in this course. And advanced GT for JEE Advanced 2021 is also happening in special classes. So tomorrow is the day when both GT as well as the special classes are there. There are two special classes for advanced. So we'll be having three sessions tomorrow, especially for JEE Advanced 2021. And advanced courses for JEE 2022 is already going on in Hindi and English. Guys, you can access my theory courses, which are of advanced plus plus levels. And for boosting your JEE preparation, you can unlock these courses on Unacademy using my code Nitin Sir. And for more info, you can visit www.unacademy.com. And guys, trust me, physics will never be the same again. So here is the problem statement. A non-conducting solid sphere is of radius r, is having uniform charge density of rho naught. The dielectric constant of the sphere is k. What is the potential at the center of dielectric sphere? And also draw ER graph of the sphere. So it's a non-conducting sphere, or you can say dielectric sphere having dielectric constant of K. So normally we deal this question with the K equal to 1 in standard books. So here we are taking the dielectric constant as K. So concept wise you can see I'm not going very much into the detail of dielectrics. But to give a better idea, I can just say the electric field inside the dielectric medium due to induced charges and external field is given by E inside is equal to E external by K. So what happens when we are creating external field? So some charges will induce, and the net field due to external plus induced charges, its value overall net will be E inside, and that will be E external by K. So here you can see for r less than r, if it was k equal to 1, suppose the standard case if we are having, so electric field inside the solid non-conducting sphere, we have rho r by 3 epsilon naught. It's a very standard result. So if we are having a dielectric sphere, this field is going to be by k times. So E is equal to rho r by 3 epsilon naught k for r less than r. So in this case, field will be discontinuous. So just to give you the idea that electric field E can be discontinuous, but the displacement vector D will be continuous at the boundary of this sphere. Though this D vector is not there in JEE Advanced syllabus, so we will refrain ourselves from more discussion into D. Maybe special video I'll make on D and P vector. Now for r greater than capital R, it is in the air, so directly I can use the formula of this field, and that is going to be kq by r square. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, and q is rho naught by 4 by 3 pi r cube divided by r square. So when you simplify this, we are going to get this E as rho naught r cube by 3 epsilon naught r square. So here we can plot this graph. If it was a normal sphere with the dielectric constant k equal to 1, this would have been the graph, which is the standard graph you would have studied in your class 12th. But due to the dielectric part here, suddenly this field will become by k of this. So you can see this graph will become, it will be a straight line but slightly lower compared to this, and there will be discontinuity at the surface of this sphere, and there will be some induced charges present here due to which this discontinuity we are observing here. All right, so once you have this, then we can relate field into potential. Since outside field is same, so corresponding potential also will be same. So from here I can say potential at the surface, directly I can use the formula kq by r. From infinity to the surface, when we are doing work against the previous electric field, So same result it is going to give us. So kq by r. So if I substitute the value and convert in terms of rho, so it is going to give us rho naught r square by 3 epsilon naught. And for k equal to 1, we know potential at the center is 3 by 2 times potential at surface. So in the end, whatever result we will get in terms of k, we are going to substitute k equal to 1, and we will verify this fact that ratio is 3 by 2 between center and the surface. So now I can move from point C to the surface. I know the potential at the surface, I know the field here. So I can use this famous equation, V final minus V initial is equal to minus integral E dot dr. So initial point is C here, and final point I'm taking at surface. So now you can see V final minus V initial is equal to minus E dot dr. This E and dr vector both are in same direction, so it will simply become E dr. So V surface, just now we have calculated rho r square by 3 epsilon naught minus Vc is equal to minus 0 to r rho r by 3 epsilon naught k dr. So when you integrate this and simplify, we are going to get Vc is equal to rho r square by 6k epsilon naught times 2k plus 1. This is going to be the answer for this problem. It's slightly uncommon problem, but you should know the variation due to this k. I hope now you know this result. So we can verify here for k equal to 1. We will check this result if it is verified or not. So Vc we are getting here by putting k equal to 1, you will get rho r square by 2 epsilon naught. And V surface we are going to get as rho r square by 3 epsilon naught. So it is maintained, it is following that relation. So guys, this is it in this video. I hope you have learned something new. And maybe many people will already know these concepts and this problem also. So if you have enjoyed this video, please leave a like, share this video with others, and I'll be coming up very soon with another video. Thank you. Thanks for watching it.